So in fact that's what Tika says. Tadap pramanyo bhavai parmartham kvachit ityadina uktam dushanam avatare. Just read parmartham kvachit shastram kvachit chapyam ritatmadam. So what was said there, same dushanam will be there if karmakanda is not pramanam. Ityaha ekadesha sedi. And Upanishad bhagaha vedaha. So Vedasyavya pramanata, then Upanishad also will lose his pramanata. Sarvanasha svargapavargayo ayogaha. Then karmakanda is not pramanam, so there is no point in svarga. Upanishad is not pramanam, apavarga or moksha also becomes of pramana. There is nothing in the life, neither abhyudaya nor nishreyasa. These are the two subject matters that the Vedas talk about. And if there is no abhyudaya nishreyasa, if those material prosperity or spiritual prosperity, then human being has nothing to do. And so, sarvanasha, there will be nothing in the human life. Then we ask him, ukta dosha nirasastarhi katham? So this dosha, apapramanyam and sarvanasha, so how do you remove this dosha? Ida vipratyaha, idi ashankyaha, ataha iti. So the next verse is, ato virodha nutyartham, not virodha but virodha nutyartham, satyatva pratipatte karikaranayo shastram puramityadinavadata. Ataha virodha nutyartham. In order to eliminate this virodha, satyatva pratipattaye, and that we can understand and we can gain the knowledge of satya, arrive at satya, the truth. Karyakaranayoho satyatva pratipattaye, there is no virodha between karya and karana or dvaita and advaita. And karyakaranayoho satyatva pratipattaye, for us to arrive at the satyatva, the truthfulness of both dvaita and advaita, shastram Purnamityayadana avadata. So Purnamada, Purnamidam, this is what the Shastra said, in order to eliminate or remove any contradiction between the Karya and the Karana and Virodha Nityartham. So Karya Karanaho Satyatva Pratipatte, and to arrive at the Satyata or Purnata of both Karya and Karana, Dvaita and Advaita, this is what Shruti said. So ataha, what is ataha? Dvaita satyatva anangikare purvakta dosha atashabdartha. Dvaita satyatva anangikare. If you don't accept the satyata of dvaita, the dosha that we just said of sarvanasha, since the sarvanasha will happen if you do not accept the satyata of dvaita, therefore Shruti said dvaita also is satyam, advaita also is satyam. Avadat Purnatva Vidishesha. So Shastram Purnam Ityadina Purnatvam Avadat Karya Karanayoho. So Satyatva Pratipatte Shastram Karya Karanayoho Purnatvam Avadat. So Purnamadaha Purnamidam Ityadina, by that statement Shastra has said Purnatvam, the wholeness of both Karya and Karana. So through Ataha Virodha Nutyartham, to eliminate this virodha, that one part is pramanam, other part is not pramanam. And satyatva pratipatte, that we arrive at satyatva, the truth, Shruti said, kari karanayaho punatvam punamityadana avadat. Shastra said, the punatvam, the wholeness of kari and karana, by the statement, punamadaha punamidam. न केवलम श्रुतेव द्वैत सत्यत्वम किंतु अध्यक्षादेह अपि. एंड आल्सो नॉट ओनली दैट द द्वैत सत्यत्वम, द ड्युअलिटी इज रियल नॉट मेल इन द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ व्हाट द श्रुति सेज बट किंतु अध्यक्षादेह अपि प्रत्यक्षादेह अपि. बाय एक्सपीरियंस आल्सो वी सी द सॉलिडिटी ऑफ द द्वैत, द ड्युअलिटी, द वर्ल्ड दैट वी एक्सपीरियंस. pratikshadini. Then the last verse, pratikshadini manani vedagrahini sarvada tesham chapya pramanatvam prapadad dvaitavadinah. Pratikshadini manani vedagrahini sarvada. See, all the perception, the pramana that we have, the perception, inference, all of these of course are based on the sense perception. All of these are sarvada bheda grahini. All the means of knowledge that we have, they always function in the realm of duality. The three one is different from the other, the drashta is different from drishya, one drishya is different from the other drishya, ghata is different from pata. Thus in all this duality or in the diversity alone, all the pramanas have their scope. In short, all the perception that we have, all the experience that we have, all that reveals only duality, duality, duality. That all differences alone are revealed by the perception, and all the pramanas based on perception. So, mana bheda grahini sarvada, tesham chabhya pramanatvam. So, advaita vadina. For the Advaitavadi, not only Veda will lose the Pramanyam, because Karma Kanda deals with the world which is according to you Mithya. And if Karma Kanda loses Pramanyam, then Jnana Kanda also will lose Pramanyam, because if one part is false or one part is unreliable, other part also becomes unreliable. Not only that, but all our experience which also reveals only duality, that experience also will lose its pramanyam according to you. And therefore we say that the world Brahma Satyam, Jagat Satyam. Brahma also is real, Jagat also is real. This is the Purapaksha. All of this is Bhadra Prapancha Purapaksha, which very beautifully has been brought out by Vartikara. It is Purapaksha. So we now go back to the page 1364. No, more than that, in fact. 1366, actually. Of course, this Purapaksha also has been replied by Bhashyakara. Tadasat, on 1364, Bhashyaka said, Tadasat, Vishishta Vishaya, Apavada Vikalpayaho, Asambhavat, all of this is false. So, when, since we discussed this Purapaksha for 3 days, we should also briefly go through the refutation of Purapaksha. Tadasat, all of this that you said is false. Vishishta Vishaya, Apavada Vikalpayaho Asambhavat. So, Apavada and the Vikalpa, the exception and the choice which are available with reference to something which is, that is Vishishta or qualified, this Vikalpa and Apavada, exception and choice are not available with reference to that which is unqualified. Nahiyam Suvikshita Kalpana. This view is not well considered. The Dvaita Dvaitatmakam Brahma and Dvaitam also is Satyam, Advaitam also is Satyam, this is not a well considered view. You are not given thought to it properly. You are fascinated by the idea, that's true. It's a very fascinating idea, you know, that like Samudra and, you know, everything is real, you know, and as Dvaita also real, Advaita also is real. All this is fascinating perhaps to you, but you have not really thought about it well, you are not considered from all the angles, and therefore you are. So people get fascinated by their own ideas, you know, and then they project it. So this is one of those things. Nahiyam suvikshita kalpana. Kasmat, why do you say that? We said all of this in support of our view. It says, yatha kriya vishaye utsarga praptasya ekadesha apavadha kriyate. So in the kriya it is all right that nahimsyat sarva bhutani, you should not in fact kill or injure animals anywhere. So this is the kriya of doing something. Yatha ahimsan sarvabhutani anyatra tisebhedi himsa sarvabhuta vishaya utsargena nivarita. So sarvabhuta vishaya himsa utsargena nivarita, by the general rule, the himsa or the injuring of the creatures which has been prohibited by the general rule. Tirthe vishishta vishaya yogishtamado anujnayate, that himsa is permitted with reference to the shastra. So wherever the shastra injunctions are there, like Jyotishtamado, that himsa is permitted, even though himsa is prohibited in general. I have a footnote here with reference to that statement, by the way. Ahimsam sarabhutani anyatra tirthe bhyaiti. So this statement comes from where? Did it come from Chandogya Upanishad? Chandogya Upanishad. So it is said that, in fact, even when it is said anyatra tirthe bhya, so with reference to other than what the Shastra says, other than what the Shastra says, you should not injure creatures anywhere. He said that in that statement, in fact, there is no himsa permitted at all. It looks like that anyatra tirthebhyah, in places other than where the scripture says the injury should not be done. That means that injury is permitted with reference to scriptural injunctions or scriptural matters, looks like. But that is also not meant, that is not what is meant there. In fact, even there also the non-violence alone is supported. So anyatra tirthebhyah, in the bhashya, this is how it is explained in Chandogya Upanishad. Bhiksha nimittam atanadinapi parapira syaditi. So Shastra permits bhikshatanam for a Mahatma. So for instance, said bhikshatanam, going and begging the alms is permitted. Because he himself is without any means. And accepted that even a sannyasi or a wise person also should sustain his body, should not abuse the body or should not be negligent about it, and therefore the basic needs of the body should be provided for. Kshud vyadisya chikitsitam, that's all. Pratidinam bhikshavshadam bhujyadam. And so the vyadi or the disease, the recurring disease of the nature of hunger, that should be chikitsitam. That must be treated. How? By the aushadam, by the medicine of the natural bhiksha, then you should gain every day. But now there is a general rule here. Ahimsam sarvabhutani, that you should not injure any creatures. So this person will say that even if I go for bhikshatanam, for begging the food, then also there is always a possibility that some creatures may be injured. Even when you walk on the road, for example, it is possible that some creatures may get hurt. And therefore, ahimsan sarabhutane, so I should not injure any creature at all, that would perhaps make this person not even go out for bhiksha. Because even that also involves some himsa. In which case, he'll do greater himsa of ignoring or neglecting his body. And so, if somebody says that statement, ahimsan sarabhutani, one should not injure any creature at all, that would prohibit any action also, because every action will always involve some himsa. Sarvarambhaya doshena dhumena agnirivavrutaha. Just as there is some smoke involved with every kind of fire, and so also some injury will be involved in any kind of action that you perform. Either physical injury, some injury, you know, something or the other. So even when we refute the Purva Paksha is injured. When you support Purupaksha, the Siddhanta is injured. Support anything and somebody is injured. Praise somebody and somebody is, you know, is in a way not praised, you know. Oh, you spoke beautifully, that means somebody else did not speak beautifully. Whatever it is. And so regardless of what you say, what you do, it's always going to bring about some injury. That means for you not to injure anything, you must be just quiet and you must be only in samadhi. So, no movement at all, any movement will involve some injury. And that's what will be asked. Then, so anyatra tirthebhyah. Then he said that the injury or the himsa is permitted in the subject matters which have a sanction of the scriptures. Tirtham nama shastra anujnya vishaya. So anyatra tirthebhyah. What is tirtha? That which is permitted or sanctioned by the scriptures. Tata anyatra ahimsan. That one should not injure anywhere other than what is permitted by the Shastra. The idea is that Shastra permits this wise person or a renunciate also to go for bhiksha, and therefore the injury that may possibly take place during that bhiksha is also permitted. that injury will not bring about any dosha. Otherwise, himsa will bring about dosha, but the himsa that takes place in performing your duties or in doing what the scripture asks you to do, there that injury or himsa will not bring about any dosha. The idea is that you do not deliberately want to injure anything when you go out for bhiksha. But it may take place inadvertently anyway. So, it's all right. At least you must be careful and alert, careful to make sure that you don't injure anything. But still, if inadvertently something happens, that is permitted because you are doing something that is essential. So, if the Shruti says certain things are essential, which are required to do, like sustaining your body is essential, and so going out of bhiksha also becomes essential, in that case, if some himsa takes place inadvertently, then that will be permitted. That's all. But Bhashyakara says here is that in terms of kriya, this kind of general rule, an exception is possible. Not in case of truth, that generally truth is non-dual, but during creation, etc., it becomes dual, this kind of exception cannot be. Nacha tatha vastu vishaye yaha dvaitam brahma utsargena pratipadya punah tadekadeshe apavaditum shakyade. But with reference to vastu, the truth, this cannot be that Brahman is non-dual in general, but then part of it becomes, or in some avastha it becomes dual. This kind of thing cannot be. Vastu is that which ever remains the same. That is called the truth. Brahmana advaitatvadeva ekadesha anupattehe. Since Brahman is non-dual, homogeneous, ekarasam, it cannot have part, and therefore it cannot be that one part of Brahman is dvaitatmakam and rest of Brahman is advaitatmakam. It cannot be. Because it is non-dual and therefore partless. Tatha vikalpa anupattesya. There cannot be vikalpa or a choice that either it is dual or non-dual. Yatha atiratre shodashinam grunnati na atiratre shodashinam grunnati iti. In the atiratre yaga, sometimes, he has a choice whether to take the vessel called shodashi or not to take it. Iti grahana grahayo purushadinatva vikalpaha bhavati. So in that yaga, this kind of vikalpa or choice is there because it is dependent upon the person whether do it or not. Natu eva tatha vastu vishaye dvaitam va syat advaitam va yadi vikalpa sambhavati. But with reference to truth, it cannot be that yes, you say, well, it is truth. Yes, in parliament you can say it in one way, and then in private you can say it another way, and here you can say it different way. Truth cannot be that. There is no vikalpa. What is in one place should be in another place, then only it can be called truth. Brahman cannot be at the time of creation, it appears different, and dissolution is something different, and then these all different states are there. This kind of thing cannot be. Apurushitantratvat atmavastu nah, because atmavastu is the vastu, the reality, doesn't have any, an individual does not have freedom with reference to reality. You have to know the truth or object as it is, and not that knowledge doesn't have your choice. What to do with the object is your choice. But how to know the object is determined by the object. Virodhacha dvaita dvaitayoho ekasya. So, one thing cannot be simultaneously dual as well as non-dual. Tasmat na suvikshita iyam kalpana. So, this kalpana, that Brahma is dvaita dvaitatmakam, is not well considered. on the page 1366, continuing, Parakiya kalpana anupattau hetvantaram pratignaya shruti virodham prakadikritya nyaya virodham prakadayati. Parakiya kalpana anupattau, this kalpana of dvaita-dvaita-atmakam brahma is not tenable, is not logical, is not in keeping with the reason. For showing that this kalpana or this whole model that you have presented, as we said yesterday also, that the intention is good. Intention is to explain everything and intention to respect everything. Somehow people feel that when it is said Brahma Satyam Jagat Mithya, then by calling Jagat Mithya, somehow a disrespect is shown to Jagat. That's what people feel. Jagat is dismissed away, is not respected. And so some kind of aversion is shown towards Jagat. And that's how you want to turn people away from Jagat by calling it Mithya. No doubt one has to get turned away from Jagat someday, then alone one can get established in Brahman, no doubt about that. Basically it is said with the highest standpoint that a person recognizes Jagat as Mithya, as dependent upon Brahman, and that's how Brahman is truth. That's the only way that you can withdraw your mind, or mind can become free from the preoccupation with Jagat, only when it knows it as Mithya. As long as Jagat is thought to be Satyam, or anything is thought to be Satyam, the mind cannot become free from its preoccupation. Mind will become free only when it understands it as Mithya. Not understanding. So where Vedantin comes from? After all, Vedanta is only meant for knowing truth. Veda is meant for knowing the truth, or Vedanta. Upanishad's only purpose is to know the truth. And therefore we have to tell what the truth of what it is. That Jagat also has certain truth that is called Mithya. And Brahman has truth which is called Satyam or Paramarthikam. So that happens to the reality. There is nothing emotional about it. And when you know Mithya is Mithya, then alone your mind can drop it. Otherwise the mind will hang on to Satyam, because the Buddhi always has and has naturally an affinity for truth. And as long as it thinks that the world is true, it will not give it up. It is that which distracts the mind ultimately. All the raga-dveshas come from ultimately taking the world to be real. There cannot be raga-dveshas for Mithya. An apple which is real can have raga-dvesha, but that which is not real cannot have anyway. So, we don't need that. Side is like we have this bunch of grapes, you know. As long as the things are taken as real, then there can be raga or dvesha. Or even this thing also, you know. This snake. If it is real, then there can be some problem with it. And somebody will love the snake also, then there can be raga. There are people who like snakes. And there are, most of them of course have a problem with the snake, so raga dveshas can be there. But when you know that this is a gourd of some kind, you know, and this is, then you know it's some kind of vegetable, that's what it is. If this is so, hathi sund, right, this is the elephant trunk. Or some kind of a, what is it, kai stick, drumstick, some kind of a drumstick, whatever. Then fine, it's you can enjoy it as it is. Then alone your mind is free to enjoy it. See, otherwise, if it is snake, either you are attracted to it because you love the snakes, or you are your aversion because you are afraid of snakes. One of the two feelings will be there. And moment you have some conclusion about it and some emotional association with it, then you cannot understand the truth of it. Either because, oh, I love this snake, then also you are not objective about it. And I hate the snake, then also you are not objective about it. So both the love, you can be free from love and hate only when you know that it is Mithya, then alone that you are objective. And then you can, if necessary, you can withdraw your mind from it. So let fine, it's there. If it is real snake, even if you withdraw your mind, some part of the mind always will, every time you'll open the eye and see, is it still there or not? It's still there. You always be concerned about it. Or if you love the snake, then also you're concerned. It has not gone away. It should not go away. It should remain there. So if you have an attraction for it, then you will want it to remain there. If you have hatred for it, you will want it to go away. And therefore, both in either case, you will open your eyes and see, even if you are meditating upon something, every now and then you will open the eyes and see whether it is there or not. Or has it not gone away yet? When it is mithya, you know it is fine wherever it is. It is here, then also it is fine. Somewhere else, also is fine. Mithya is that which can be enjoyed as it is. There is no demand. My mind becomes non-demanding with reference to mithya. Whatever the curvature is fine, whatever the length is fine, whatever diameter is fine, because it is not a snake, mithya. And so, mithya means there is a total acceptance, total comfort. With satya, there is total comfort with truth also. But if it is mithya and taken to be truth, there can't be comfort. If it is truth and taken to be mithya, then also there can't be comfort. There is no comfort in our life. Atma, which is truth, is taken to be limited. There is no comfort with that. And the world, which is untrue or mithya, is taken to be real. Then there is no comfort. So, recognizing the realities as they are, there is a total comfort. Then alone the mind can understand the truth as it is and can abide in the truth. Then I can at will engage my mind in this object or disengage it as I will. Yada samharde chayam kurvangani va sarvashah indriyani indiyarthebhyah tasya prajna pratishthita. That prajna pratishthita. So, siddha prajnatvam can be there when at will, like a tortoise, I can withdraw my mind or sense organs from the things at will. And at will I can expand them also or stretch them out. So this is the idea of the Brahma Satyam, Jagan Mithya and nothing else. Tasmanna suvikshada evan kalpana, therefore this kalpana is not well considered. The intention is good, but what you arrive at, it is not right. Then, hetvantaram pratijnaya, then Bhashyakara gives other hetu also, as to how this kalpana is not suvikshada, not well considered. So the next statement says on the page 1366, Shruti Nyaya Virodhacha Hetvantara, other two hetus, Shruti and Nyaya Virodha. So this kalpana will contradict the Shruti statements as well as will go against the very reason. So it is not, it contradicts or it militates against the reason and it completely contradicts what the Shrutis say. So, hetvantaram pratijnaya, Bhashyakara has made the pratijna of providing other hetus, Shruti and Nyaya Virodha. So, Shruti Virodha is one hetu and Nyaya Virodha another hetu, by which it is said, na suvivakshita yam kalpana. This kalpana is not well considered for yet two reasons, Shruti Virodhat, Nyaya Virodhat cha. Of that, Shruti Virodham Prakati Krutya, Bhashyakara first of all makes it clear in what way this kalpana contradicts or opposes what the Shruti says. So Bhashya says further, Saindhava Ghanavata Prajnanaikara Saghanam Nirantaram Purvapara Bahyabhyantara Bheda Vivarjitam Sabahyabhyantaram Ajam Neti Neti Asthulam Anana Akhrasvam Ajaram Abhayam Ajam Ajaram Abhayam Amrutam ityevamadyaha shrutayah nischitarthaha संशय विपर्यासा शंका रहिताः सर्वाः समुद्रे प्रक्षिप्ता स्युः अकिंचित् करत्वात्। See, if you say that Brahman is anekarasam, bahurasam, heterogeneous, not homogeneous, not ekarasam, then all these shrutis which declare Brahman is ekarasam, as homogeneous, admitting no kind of differences within itself or without itself, so all these statements of shruti will be all redundant. Samudre prakshipta syuhu, all of these will be thrown out the window. Akinchit karatvad, like a trash. So like the trash you throw away things out of window, so also this statement of Shruti also will be thrown away. What statement? Saindhava ghanavat prajnaneka ghana rasaghanam. Saindhava ghanavat. Like the lump of salt. Like a dense lump of salt. Prajnaneka ghana rasaghanam. Similarly also Brahman is prajnaneka rasaghanam. Is nothing but the dense mass of consciousness, meaning it is pure consciousness. Admitting of nothing other than consciousness, the idea is that within the consciousness nothing else is admitted. All that is this consciousness alone. There is no such thing as mithya and maya and jada ultimately in the ultimate analysis. All that is nothing but pure consciousness, just Brahman. Nirantaram, which is no antara, which there is no crevices at all. There is no crevices within itself. Purvapara bahya bhyantara bhedavarjitam. There is no purva, no apurva, no karanam, nor karyam, no bahyam, no abhyantaram. No exteriorness, no interiorness. None of these kind of distinctions are admitted in Brahma. So bahya bhyantaram ajaha. That which simultaneously obtains outside as well as inside, with ajaya, unborn. In short, all kind of distinctions are negated here. Neti neti. So, divyo khyamurtah purushah sabakhya abhyantarah ajaya apranah amanah, all of this is nothing but negating all the distinctions in Brahman. So, that's what neti neti does. Eliminating or rather negating all kinds of distinctions in Brahman. Like asthulam, ananu, akhraswam, ajam, ajaram, abhayam, amritam. It is neither fat nor lean, nor long nor short, no birth, no decrepitude, no free from fear, free from birth, free from decrepitude, free from death, free from fear. Evamadhyaha shrutayaha, all these and many other shrutis of this nature which deny all distinctions in Brahma, which reveal very clearly Brahman that is devoid of any distinctions, which ekarasam homogeneous, so all and one without a second, all of these statements, nischitartha, these are statements which are nischitartha, meaning of which the meaning of which is very ascertained, leaving no doubt at all. So there are certain statements in the scriptures also which are subject to debate, which are available for perhaps different interpretations, but not these statements. Aja is aja, asthulam, ananu, akhraswam, adirgham, ajam and amaram, abhayam, ajaram, all are very clear. Samshaya vipariyasa ashanka rahitaha, without the doubt of samshaya, without the without samshaya, viparyasa ashanka. There is no doubt, there is no error, and at the same time, there is no kind of ashanka also means again doubt. So samshaya means two different kotis are there. So both of them may appear to be true. That's called samshaya. Viparyaya means taking thing to be opposite or different from what it is. Ashanka means having doubt about what it is. Okay, so this is number 2. Nacha etasam upasanadi parthunyaha samshaya viparyasa ashanka. Somebody may say that all these statements are all right, but they don't talk about Brahman. They talk about meditation upon Brahman. So such doubts are also not there. All the doubts have been resolved. And so, there is no samshaya that these statements refer to Brahman. There is no viparyaya that they can lead to some contrary conclusions. Or ashanka that they can still retain some doubt in your mind. These statements are very clear, very explicit. Sarvaha samudre prakshiptaha sihu. All of these will be thrown overboard. Let's call samudre, if you are thrown overboard. Akinchit karatma, like trash, thrown overboard, you know. And that just doesn't make sense. So, Shruti Virodham Prakade Kritya. In this statement, Bhashyakara has brought to light the Virodha contradiction that obtains with the Shruti or Upanishad when you accept this view that Brahman is Dvaita Dvaitatmakam. The Nyaya Virodham Prakatevi. Shruti Nyaya Virodhacha. So, of that, the Shruti Virodha, that Hetu has been clarified. Nyaya Virodham, how it contradicts the reason also. Prakatayati, Bhashyakara brings it out, Tathayati. Then Bhashya says, Tatha Nyaya Virodhopi. So, Tatha, similarly, Nyaya Virodhapi. Says Anandagiri, Brahmanaha Anekarasatve Syadati Sheshaha. Tatha Brahmanaha Anekarasatve Nyaya Virodhopi Syad. Thus, similarly also, if you accept Brahma as heterogeneous, containing the duality within itself, then Nyaya Virodha, it will also contradict the reason. How Bhashyakara says, Savayavasya Anekatmakasya Kriyavatah Nityatva Anupattehe. So you are presenting Brahman for which your example is Samudra. Savayavasya. Thus Brahman becomes, consists of, Brahman contains parts. Like ocean has parts, it is water and the waves and bubble and foam, and so Brahman also is Dvaita and Advaita. So Savayavam, consisting of parts. Anekatmakasya, it is more than one Atma. Dvaita, Dvaita Atmakasya, Dvaita also is the nature of Brahman, and Advaita also is the nature of Brahman. Anekatmakatva. So Atmana, Anekatmakasya, and Kriyavataha, Nrityati, Samudravat Nrityati, you know, Pratyavastam Vibhu. And so it is dancing. So Kriya, that means what? It is Kriyavata, that which is possessed of, so Kriya, it is changing. It is subject to movement and change, and therefore Vikara also is subject to change, and therefore ultimately destruction. Nityatva Anupatte. It just doesn't make sense that something that is possessed of parts can be eternal. Because parts will always separate. The parts will come together for a certain reason. They are held together also for a certain reason. There is some bond which holds the parts together. But whatever it is that causes bond, when that goes away, the parts will go their way. Sarve sanyogaha vyogantaha. All the association ultimately will culminate into or result into disassociation. This is the rule. And therefore, savayavam, the body also, made of different parts, the parts will get separated as the time comes. They get deteriorated. Ultimately, they will wither away and they will go their own way. So, savayavam, number one. So, that is a composite entity consisting of many parts or many elements or ingredients, that can never be nitya, can never be eternal. It will never remain the same. That the parts always have a tendency to separate away. And when the force that is bonding them together, when that becomes weaker and weaker, ultimately separation will take place. So, there cannot be nityatvam, eternality. Anekatmakasya. Or Dvaita is one Atma, Advaita, other Atma, two Atmas will always, if they are contradicted to each other, then they will always fight. If there are more than one Atma in my own body, then one Atma may want to eat, other Atma may want to drink, and one Atma may want to do something else. That being the case, there will never be any harmony at all, and so that this will be destroyed. Kriyavataha. Thirdly, when something is active, something is subject to action or movement. Movement is change, something is subject to change. That means it is subject to decay, and someday it will perish. So, that which is possessed of activity or movement or change can never be eternal. Eternal must necessarily be homogeneous. It must necessarily be ekātmakatva, meaning it must have one nature alone, which of course is what is meant by homogeneousness, homogeneity, and it also must be free from any vikriya, free from any change. Then alone it can be nitya or eternal, and Brahma, the truth, must be eternal. That alone is called truth, which is ever the same. And if you project or posit the truth in this manner, then it can never satisfy the criterion of truth. Nityatva anupattehe. So, Siddhanandagiri, nityatva anupattehe, atmanah nityatva angikara virodasyat. And then you certainly want Atma to be nitya. You also would desire that Brahman and Atma must be nitya, on one hand. On the other hand, by presenting Brahman and Atma as heterogeneous, as composite entity, as kriyavan, you are denying the nityatva. And so, the very position that you presented itself will contradict the nityatva of the moksha or the Atma that you desire. Nanu tasya nityatvam na angikriyate. All right. We say that Atma is not nitya. What? So what? Suppose. Nanu tasya nityatvam na angikriyate. So we don't accept nityatvam. We say Brahman is dvaitadvaitatmakam, but it's not nityam. Mana bhava. Because where is the pramanam? To show that Brahman or Atma is nitya, where is the pramanam? In fact, they look upon Atma also as part of Brahman. Atma is anitya and Brahman is some, you know. So because our experience is that Jivatma is anitya, so that is also accepted in some way. Or change is accepted. So Atmana nityatvam na angikriyate, we do not accept Atma as nitya. Mana bhavat, because there is no pramanam. There is no valid means of knowledge to prove the nityatvam, the eternality of Atma. Idi prasangikim ashankam patya. It's not part of discussion with Bhartru Prapancha. But when we are refuting him and when we are establishing Atma as nitya, somebody can say that, well, suppose Atma is not nitya, so what? Then everything is okay? Says no. So nityatvam cha. So next statement says nityatvam cha. आत्मनः स्मृत्यादि दर्शनात् अनुमीयते. बट नो नित्यत्वम् अनुमीयते, नित्यत्वम् स्वीक्रियते. सो वी से दैट आत्मा इज नित्य ऑन अकाउंट ऑफ स्मृति स्मृत्यादि दर्शनात्. आनंद एक्सप्लेन दैट स्मृत्यादि दर्शनात् इति आदि शब्देन सैवतु कर्मानुस्मृति शब्दादि शब्द विषय विधिभ्य इति अधिकरणोक्ता हेतवः गृह्यन्ते. दिस इज ए सूत्र अधिकरण फ्रॉम ब्रह्म सूत्र. सैवतु कर्म अनुस्मृति शब्द विधिभ्य इति. आत्मा इज द सेम बिफोर स्लीप एंड आफ्टर स्लीप. द सेम आत्मा इज देयर बिकॉज ऑफ कर्म अनुस्मृति शब्द एंड विधि. बिकॉज ऑफ दिस आत्मा इज द सेम. दिस इज विल लुक एट दैट ब्रह्मसूत्र टुमारो. आई जस्ट रीड द भाष्य क्विकली. बट आफ्टर फ्रॉम ऑल ऑफ दैट ऑल्सो इज एस्टैब्लिश्ड आत्मा इज नित्य. यू कैन नॉट से आत्मा इज अनित्य. So at this time it is said nityatvam cha atmanah smrutyadarshanat anumiyate. Anumiyate inferred. But inferred means here accepted. You would accept the nityatvam or eternality of the atma based on all these various reasons that are given in that adhikaranam of Brahma Sutra. We'll see tomorrow. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Vadarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyoma Vadvyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namaha Om Shanti 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 Hari Om. Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Kham Brahma Kham Puranam Vayuram Kham Idhasmaha Kauravyayani Putraha Vedoyam Brahmana Viduhu Vedainena Yadveditavyam. This is page 1366. Bhashyakara gives some further reasons why the view presented by Bhartru Prapancha is not a well-considered view of imagining Brahman to be dvaita-dvaita-atmakam, of both dvaita as well as advaita. It was said that in nirvishesh vastu there cannot be a situation such as general rule and exception. Also there cannot be a situation where there is a choice, nor can there be a situation where the two contrary things are being together. Virodhaccha dvaita dvaita tvayoho ekasya tasmanna suvikshatayam kalpana shrutinyaya virodhaccha. And this kalpana of imagining dvaita brahma as dvaita dvaitatmakam also contradicts the shruti, what the scriptures reveal, as well as nyaya, the reasoning. Saindhav ghanavat prajnanaika rasaghanam Nirantaram Uruvapara Bhakya Bhyantara Veda Vivarjitam Sabhakya Bhyantaram Ajam Neti Neti Astulam Nanu Ajam Ajaram Afayam Amratam Ityam Adhyaha Shrutayaha Nishchitarthaha Samshavipriyasa Ashankarahitaha Sarvaha Samudre Prakshiptaha Sivu Akinchit Karatvad. All the Shrutis that declare Brahman as one non-dual homogeneous, without parts, without posterior, without anterior, interior, exterior, this one homogeneous whole, all these shrutis, and in these statements leave no doubt and no error whatever in understanding what they mean. All these statements will be thrown overboard, samudre prakshiptaha sihu, because they are of no meaning at all, so all of these become useless. Tatha nyaya virodhopi, and also this goes against the reasoning as well. Because Brahma must be nityam, and if you, as you say, Brahma is dvaita dvaitatmakam, That means that one part of Brahman is Dvaita, other part of Brahman is Advaita. Because they are contradictory, therefore somehow they are there, the two contradictory things are there, and therefore it is Savayamam, consisting of these avayavas or these parts. Savayavasya anekatmakasya, Brahma is anekatmakam, Dvaita dvaitatmakam. So Dvaita also is Atma of Brahma, means nature of Brahma, Advaita also is nature of Brahma, and therefore anekatmakam. Kriyavataha, and you say that there is avirbhava, tarobhava, also is happening, that karya comes into manifestation, again goes back into the karanam, and thus there is a kriya also. So kriyavataha, nityatva anupattehe, any entity which possesses this kind of characteristics cannot be nitya, cannot be eternal. And so what? So Anandagiri said, nityatva anupattehe atmanah nityatvangikara virodasyadity adhyahara. If this is so, then atma is accepted as nitya because moksha must be nitya, and as you present Brahman as dvaita dvaitatmakam, it only turns out to be anityam, in which case accepting atma as nitya, that turns out to be wrong or it contradicts the accepted fact that Atma or Brahman must be nitya, then the truth must be nityam. Then the truth of the reality must be eternal. It must be beyond the limitations of time, and there are place and conditions that alone can be called truth, and this becomes a conditional reality, and therefore it contradicts the very concept of satya or the reality. Then says, nanu tasya nityatvam na angikriyate mana bhava. He says, well, we don't see the need of looking upon Atma as nitya or as eternal, as beyond all the limitations of time, etc. Mana bhava, because there is no pramana to show that Atma is nitya. Iti prasangikim ashankam pratyaha. This incidental question that may be raised, you know, the doubt that can be raised, also is being replied here. Nityatvam cha. So Vashyakara said, nityatvam cha atmanah smrutya darshanat anumiyate. That atma is nitya, you pramana bhava. Suppose Shruti says that, all right, but then do you have any of the pramana other than Shruti to verify the nityatvam, the eternality or continuity of atma? So smrutyadi darshanat anumiyate. We can infer the nityatvam, infer the eternality or continuity of the atma. Basically the question is whether atma is there in sushupti or not, so that atma persists before sleep and after sleep, the same atma, that can be anumiyate, that can be inferred. And so Anandagiri said, smrutyadi darshanatya iti adi shabdena smrutyadi darshanat. So there is a smruti. When this person wakes up in the morning, he has this memory. So sukhamaham aswapsam na kinchit avedisham. I slept happily, I did not know anything. This is called smruti. And ya smruti sa anubhav purvika. The memory must be preceded by an experience. So when he has a memory in the morning that I slept happily, I did not know anything, that means that he must have the experience of happiness and not knowing anything. That means that he, the experiencer, must be there in the deep sleep state also to experience this. That's called the smruti. Adi. So Anandagiri says, adi darshanat or adi shabdena Brahma Sutra. Saevatu karma anusmruti shabda vidibhya iti adhikaranoktaha hetavaha grihyante. And several other hetavaha, many other reasons are also provided in that adhikarana Brahma Sutra to show how atma persists even during the deep sleep state. What is meant by anumiyate? Not inferred, but anumiyate, kalpyate, svikriyate iti yavat. Thus we can imagine, we can presume, or we can accept the persistence of Atma. I just want to read for you the Brahma Sutra Bhashya here. Karmanusmriti Shabda Vidibhyah Saivatu. It must be the same Atma. The fellow wakes up in the morning, must be the same one that went to sleep. You see, we just take things for granted, but all these questions can be asked. Because in Chandogya Upanishad, all this discussion comes. Sada, sata, tada, tada, sata, somya, sampanno, bhavati. In the state of deep sleep, the Jivatma becomes merged into Sat or Paramatma. And then again arises. So the question asked here is, tasya punaha satsampatrehe pratibuddhimanaha. So this is on page 635 of this book, if anybody has it. The sutra is, 329. तस्याः पुनः सत्संपत्तेः प्रतिबुद्धिमानः किम् येव सत्संपन्नः सैव प्रतिबुद्ध्यते उत सव अन्यो वा इति चिन्त्यते. सो व्हेन इट इज सेड इन चांदोग्य उपनिषद दैट आत्मा मर्जेस इनटू सत और इनटू ब्रह्मन और रियलिटी द लिमिटलेस, देन ए क्वेश्चन अराइजेस. सत्संपत्तेः प्रतिबुद्धिमानः, सो नो वेक्स अप having reached the state of Sat or Brahman, or having merged into Brahman, having become Brahman, when he wakes up again, kim yaheva sat sampannaha saeva pratibuddhyate. That fellow who has merged into Brahman, is it the very same one who wakes up? Uta sava anyava iti chintyate. Uta, he is the same one or someone else? So it is a jiva who wakes up, or Ishvara who wakes up, or someone else who wakes up. Who wakes up? Tatra praptam tavat aniyamaheti. We don't see any niyam or the rule that the person who merged into the infinite must necessarily wake up, you know, from the infinite. This limited being merges into infinite. Having merged into infinite, what's the rule that the same fellow should wake up from that? So tatra praptam tavat aniyamahiti. So we find that there is no rule the same entity should wake up. Kutaha, we ask him, what makes you say that? He gives an example. Yadahi jalarasho kasti jalabindu prakshipyade jalarashi eva satadabhavati punaruddharanicha. Saiva jalabinduhu bhavati iti dussampadam. Like you see, what is Sat or Brahman is infinite, like ocean. And this jiva is like a drop of water. So when a drop of water merges into the ocean, then it becomes ocean. Saiva tada jalarasihi bhavati, he becomes the very ocean. And then when you pick up the drop, can you say that the very same drop will be picked up? Punaruddharaye sachaeva jalabindu bhavati iti dussampadam. It is impossible to make sure that when you pick up the bindu or another drop that comes out is the very same drop. No one can ever say that. There is no niyama at all. Tadvat supta parena egatvapanna. Similarly also this limited being merges into limitless. Sata sampanno bhavati tada somya sada sampanno bhavati. When in this deep sleep state, he merges into infinite. Then, it's like merging of a drop into ocean. How can you say the same entity comes out when he wakes up? Tadvat supta parena ekatvapannaha samprasidati iti. Because it says he attains samprasada, he attains the quietude, quintessence. Thus, at that time, there is no individuality. The idea is that samprasidati, he becomes of the nature of quintessence. He becomes nature of total tranquility. That means there is no individuality at all there in a state of deep sleep. And then, so, nasaheva punaruttanam arhati. When he goes into the ocean of quintessence or tranquility, How can you say that? The same drop of restlessness again wakes up. Tasmat saeva ishvarahava anyava jivaha pratibuddhyate iti evam prapta idamaha. So we say that either it is Ishvara wakes up, or the same jiva wakes up, or some other jiva wakes up. Aniyamaha prapta. That's all we are saying, that there is no rule. Idi evam prapta, when this situation arises, idam uchyate, this is what is said. Then sutra says, so saevatu, what is it? Saevatu jivaha suptaha swasthyam gataha punarutishtati nanyaha saevatu. And so all the discussion is in continuation of the previous sutra, although this forms its own adhikaran, but the same thing is going on. So Sushupti discussion is going on with the help of Chandogya Upanishad as well as Brihadaranyaka Upanishad statements. We did this when we were studying Chandogya Upanishad in the olden days anyway, but it's many years ago. So evam prapta idamaha saiva tu jivaha suptaha swasthyam gataha. So same jiva who went to sleep, swasthyam gataha, who attained swasthata, its own state of tranquility, punaha uttishthati, he alone wakes up, na anyaha, not anybody else. This is what we have to say. Kasmat, on the strength of what? Because of what reason do you say that? Karmarosvati shabdavidibhya, that's the, this is the hitavaha. So saevato is pratignya bhaga, and then comes the hetu, karma rasvati shabda vidibhya. This is the way the sutra is made. Every adhikarana gives the pratignya and the hetu, sometimes the shtanta. So these three elements. So karma, anusmriti, shabda, vidhi, four and anu, five hetus are contained in that statement there. Vivajya hetum darshayishyam, he says, now all these hetus are there, I will show individual reason as to why the same jiva should wake up from the sleep. So first is karma. Karma shesha anusthana darshanat tavat sevutthatum arhati nanyah. Karma shesha anusthana darshanat, because we find that this fellow engages in completing the same action which he had initiated previously, you know. So whatever it is that he was doing the previous day, and leaving incomplete, he went to sleep the previous night. When he wakes up in the morning, he again goes back and engages himself into completing the same work. If I am knitting something, stitching something, whatever I am doing, next day this person goes to the very same work to complete that. Explains it, tathai, to explain. Purvedyuhu anushtitasya karmanaha aparedyuhu shesham anutishtan drishyate. Purvedyuhu, on the previous day, anushtitasya karmanaha, the action that was initiated on the previous day, we find that the next day, this fellow, anutishtan drishyate, is seen as being engaged in the very same action that he had started or left incomplete the previous day. नचे अन्येन सामीकृतस्य कर्मणः अन्यः शेषक्रियायां प्रवर्तितुम् अर्हति. It cannot be that somebody has left the work incomplete and somebody else should, you know, some other jiva has woke up then, some jiva left the work incomplete, and a new jiva who has no knowledge at all should proceed to complete that work that we never see. And therefore, the one who proceeds to complete the incomplete work must be the same one who must have started that work. And therefore, ati prasangat, otherwise there will be no rule at all. Or unwarranted thing, even in the world also. I did something and you completed and vice versa, and then, you know, this fellow worked for the whole month and somebody else got the salary. You know, that kind of, this rule will not be there. There will be no rule at all. Tasmat ekaheva पूर्वेद्यु परेद्यु परेद्युश्च एकस्य कर्मणः कर्ता इति गम्यते. देयरफॉर वी से दैट एकस्य कर्मणः कर्ता गम्यते एकहेव. सो दैट वन पर्सन अलोन इज अ कर्ता इज अ डूअर ऑफ वन एक्शन ऑन द प्रीवियस डे एंड द नेक्स्ट डे. दैट्स कर्म. Karma is not this Sanchita Karma and Prarabdha. Karma means Kriya, actually, action, ordinary action. And second is Anusmruti. Itascha Seva Uttishthati. So, Smruti is there, Anusmruti is there. Itascha, for this further reason we say that, it is the same fellow who wakes up from the sleep. Yat Karanam. अतीते अहनि अहम् अदो अद्राक्षमिति पूर्वानुभूतस्य पश्चात् स्मरणम् अन्यस्य उत्थानं उपद्यते. बिकॉज अतीते अहनि ऑन द प्रीवियस डे और ऑन द अर्लियर डेज अहम् अदः अद्राक्षमिति आई सॉ दिस थिंग. सो दिस लिटिल पार्ट हियर. सो आई से इन द मॉर्निंग यू नो आई सॉ दिस यस्टरडे. आई सॉ दिस मैन यस्टरडे. I saw this shirt yesterday, whatever it is. So, atidahani, on the previous day, on the day that is gone by, aham adahadraksham, I saw that thing. Iti purvanubhutasya paschasmaranam. So, this is anusmruti. Purvanubhutasya paschasmaranam. The memory later of what is experienced earlier cannot be if the fellow wakes up. It's different from the one who went to sleep. Nahi anya dushtam anya anusmrutu marhati. It's called anusmruti. Sono means in keeping with the previous experience, the memory that comes here. Nahi anya dushtam anya anusmrutu marhati. It cannot be that one can remember something that was experienced by someone else. It cannot be. And so, the one who remembers must be the same one who must have experienced it. Ya smrutihi sa anubhava purvika. Then also there is what they call pratyabhijna. See, anusmruti is of something other than you. Pratyabhijna is of your own self. Soham asmidi cha anusmranam atmantarothan navakalpate pragasvapsamidi prabodhasamaye yaf pratyabhijnayate. Prabodha samaya, when he wakes up, he is pratyabhijnayate. He recollects. Pragatsvapsam. I was the one who went to sleep last night. I am the one who wakes up in the morning. And so, sohamasmiri. So by anushabda, they also include what they call the pratyabhijna. So anusmruti, they refer to the memory of what is experienced in the earlier days. And by smruti, by anusmruti, they also include the pratyabhijna, a recollection of one's own self. Soham asmiri cha anusmaranat. That I am the same one who went to sleep last night. Anusmaranat. Anusmaranam. Atmantarothan navakalpade. If someone else wakes up in the morning, then he cannot have that recollection or recognition that I was the one who went to sleep. So that is karma, anusmruti, shabda. Shabdebhyasya tasyeva utthanam avagamyate. By shabda we mean the scriptures here. So for the scriptural statements also, it is avagamyate. We arrive at this understanding that it is the same individual, the same jiva who went to sleep. Tathahi. पुनः प्रतिज्ञायम् प्रतियोनि आद्रवति बुद्धान्तायैव इन्द्रहदारण्यक उपनिषद. सो व्हेन ही गोज फ्रॉम वेकिंग टू स्लीप एंड देन प्रतिज्ञायम् अगेन प्रतिज्ञायम् प्रतियोनि इन द सेम वे बाय द सेम रूट. सो आद्रवति बुद्धान्तायैव अगेन ही रिटर्न्स टू द स्टेट ऑफ वेकिंग. सो फ्रॉम द वेकिंग ही वेंट टू स्लीप. And by the same route again, he returns to the state of waking. This is what Brihadaranyaka Upanishad says. Then Chandogya, Sarvaha Prajaha Ahar Ahar Gacchantyah Etam Brahmalokam Navindanti. Sarvaha Prajaha, all these creatures, Ahar Ahar Gacchantyah, every day these creatures in fact go to Brahmaloka. So the state of deep sleep is described as Brahmaloka. Ahar Brahma Gamayati. Inasmuch as the jiva merges into Brahma, and therefore, in the deep sleep state, he goes to Brahmaloka. Every day, this, all the creatures go to Brahmaloka. Aharaha etam Brahmalokam navindanti. But then, they do not know that they have reached the Brahmaloka. So, when it's aharaha, day in and day out, they go to Brahmaloka. That means that, every day the same people go, and they return. Again, Chandogya Upanishad. Taiha vyagrova, simhova, vrukova, varahova, kitova, patangova, damshova, mashakova, yad yad bhavanti, tad abhavanti. This was Chandogya Upanishad, 6th chapter. And therefore, Svetikati was told, whatever it was that went to sleep, vyagrova, whether it's a tiger, simhova or lion, vrukova or a, what do you call it, wolf, right? Varahova, or a boar, or a pig, Kitova, or an insect, Patangova, or a butterfly, right, Damshova, Mashagova, whether it is a, it's what you call it, the mosquito, whatever it is, or a fly. So, yad yad bhavanti, tat abhavanti. Whatever it was that went to sleep, abhavanti, again that jiva wakes up in the same way. We are talking about one mind. No, we are talking about another jiva. See, if another jiva comes out, when I went to sleep, I was a human being. When I woke up, I'm a mosquito. And when he goes to sleep with a mosquito, he wakes up with an elephant, you know. So another jiva means what? It can be anything. If there is no niyama, then it can be anything. So, yad yad bhavanti, tat abhavanti. That's the reason why, because ignorance is there. Here it is, ignorance. That's the reason why the merging into Brahman is not enough to get them liberated, because ignorance persists, and therefore they wake up in the same way. Ityo madaya shabdaha swapa prabodha adhikare pathitaha na atmantarothane samanjasyam iyuhu. Ityevamadaya shabdaha. All these statements, svapa pravodha adhikare pathitaha. All these statements which are of the Upanishads, which are made in reference to the sleep and waking up. Na atmantarothane samanjasyam iyuhu. If another atma wakes up, as you say, then all these words or these statements, in fact, will not make sense at all. So, karma, anusmriti, shabda and vidhi. Karma vidya vidibhyasyevam evameva avagamyate. And also the fact that the shruti or the karma kanda in fact enjoins upon individuals the karma and vidya. The rituals and the meditations are enjoined upon individuals. That also shows that there must be continuity of the jiva. Anyathai karma vidya vidaya anarthakaha syuhu. If the fellow who goes to sleep is different from the fellow who wakes up in the morning, there is no rule at all, in short. Then the fellow who performed the action the previous day is not the one who woke up in the morning. Anyathai karma vidya vidaya anarthakaha syuhu. All these vidhis or injunctions of rituals and the meditations would become useless. Anyothana pakshahi supta matra mucchyate iti apadyate. So anyothana pakshahi supta matra mucchyate iti apadyate. If someone else wakes up, then whoever goes to sleep gets released, because he doesn't wake up. Evam chet syadvada kim kalantar phalena karmana vidyava krutam syad. If this is so, then please tell me, what is the purpose to be served? by performing a ritual which is going to give you a result at a future date? Or performing meditation which is going to give a result in the future world? What's the purpose of performing rituals and meditations if someone else wakes up and you are not the beneficiary? Apicha anyutthana pakshe ritavat sharirantare vyavaharamano jivaha uttishte tatra tatratya vyavahar lobha prasanga syat. And what? And then so forth and so on, it goes on, you know. And then if another the body is the same, and the fellow is different, you know. Apicha anyutthana pakshe yaditavat sharirantare vyavaharamana jiva. So jiva wakes up, if the body is the same, the fellow wakes up is different. Uttishtatratya vyavaharalo prasanga, then only vyavahara, that was done also, that will be lopa means, that would also come to an end. Atha tatra supta uttishthet kalpana anarthakyam syat. And therefore, same fellow has woken up, that kalpana would be anarthakyam syat. Yuhi yasmin charire supta sa tasmin uttishthade anyasmin charire supta anyasmin uttishthade di kahasyam kalpanayam lahasyat. Then this kalpana on our part, that the fellow who went to sleep wakes up in the same body. He may wake up somewhere else, then also is not enough, you know. He should wake up in the same body. Another fellow went to sleep in that body, should wake up in that body. This will have no meaning at all. Atha mukta uttishthet antavan moksha apadyet. You say that the liberated person in the sleep, one who is liberated, he woke up, then moksha brings avinitya. Nivritta vidyasya cha punaruthana anupannam. And so forth and so on. So this is how but anyway, still the example that was given of a drop of water, so merging into ocean, how about that? Yat puna uktam yatha jalarashau prakshiptah jalabinduhu na uddhartum shakyate evam sari sampanno jivano utpatitum arhateti. What you had said, how the drop of water that was merged into ocean, same drop of water cannot come out, similarly the same jiva cannot wake up, that was said. Tat parihiryate, this being refuted now. Yuktam tatra vivekarana bhava jalabindho anudharanam. Then it's alright, because the jalabindhu, there is no viveka, no distinction at all from the ocean water. Yadu vidyate vivekaranam karma cha vidya chaite vaishamyam. On the other hand, here every jiva possesses his or her own karma and avidya. That is what distinguishes one jiva from the others. Whereas there is nothing to distinguish one drop of water from the other drop of water. Since there is nothing to distinguish two drops of water, you can't say the same drop of water comes out. But here a jiva is distinguished from other jivas by avidya and karma. Drishyate cha दुर्विवेचयोः अपि अस्मज्जातियैः शिरोदकयोः संसृष्टयोः हंसेन विवेचनम्. And we also find that even though we cannot separate the water from the milk or milk from the water, the hamsa is known to separate. And therefore, even though the separation of jiva and brahma may be difficult, but inasmuch as they are different, inasmuch as milk and water are different, therefore they can be separated. Maybe separation may require someone very subtle or someone very skilled, you know, having some very special properties to do that. But as long as two things are different, they can be separated. Similarly, as long as two jivas are different, on account of the distinct avidya karma, therefore they can be separated. Apicha na jivo na kasit parasmadanyo vidyate yo jal binduriva jalarashe sato vicheda sadevatu upadhi sampraka jivati upacharyate iti asatkrut panchiram. A number of times we have said that jiva is not someone that is distinct from Brahman, that one distinct entity goes into merge into Brahman. Sadevatu upadhi sampraka jivati upacharyate, it is Brahman alone which because upadhi sampraka is called jiva. Iti asatkru prapanchitam, number of times we have said this. Evam sadhi,
Yavad, every time they forget, you know. And so every time they bring it back. Evam sadhi yavad ekopadigata bandhan vritti tavad eka jiva vyavahara. And so, as long as ekopadigata bandhan vritti, as long as there is persistence of bondage pertaining to one upadhi, tavad eka jiva vyavahara. So long we say that it's the same jiva. Upadhyantrakatayam to bandhan vritto jivantra vyavahara. Same fellow goes to same Brahman. When Brahman persists one upadhi, we say it's the same jiva. When same Brahman goes to other upadhi, we call it another jiva. Or one upadhi is one jiva, second is not that jiva, the real different in that sense also. It's Brahman alone which comes to be called jiva on account of identification with a given upadhi. And so same Brahman comes to be called jiva when in one upadhi, because comes to be called another jiva when another upadhi. Sevayam upadhi svava prabodeho bijankuranyayana ityata seva jiva pratibuddhyate iti uktam. Sevayam upadhi svayam, then in the waking, in the deep sleep state, same upadhi persists, and therefore Brahman identified with the same upadhi is called jiva. Therefore, when we say that, very important point, when we say that one jiva went to sleep and woke up, it is Brahman that goes to sleep. What is jiva? Same Brahman identified this upadhi. So as long as same upadhi wakes up, so long same jiva wakes up, because inherently jiva is not different from Brahman. One jiva is not inherently different from Brahman. It is Brahman alone which is called jiva when identified with the given upadhi. And same Brahman identified with another upadhi is called another jiva. So as long as the same upadhi wakes up, the upadhi that went to sleep, the same upadhi wakes up, so long Brahman comes to be called the same jiva. So eka jivatva vyavahara. So long the vyavahara is the same jiva that is woken up. Ultimately, who does all this vyavahara is Brahman alone. But comes to be called jiva on account of association with different upadhi. And therefore, the conclusion is that the same jiva wakes up. That means there is nityatvam. This is with reference to the Bauddhas, who say that in the deep sleep state there is shunyatvam. Atma is anitya, this is what they say. In argument against them, all of this is stated, is just brought here. That if Atma is anitya, then all these hetus, our experience is that Atma is nitya. And that nityatvam of the Atma will be contradicted when you take Atma as anekātmaka, dvaita, dvaitātmaka. So this was the question here. Nityatvam cha ātmanah smrutyāya darshanāt anumiyate. Anandika says, anumiyate, kalpyate, svikriyate iti yavat. Anumiyate is inferred. Kalpyate is presumed. Svikriyate means is accepted. So footnote number 6, now there is a footnote number 5, which of course says what we just read. Saivata vidhi Brahma Sutra 3-9. Yes, sukto jiva seva uttishthati nanyahiti yatra hetava karma ityadayah. So the jiva that went to sleep, the same fellow wakes up in the morning, for that all these hetus are given here. Dinadvaya sadhya karmanah ardham krutva punaruthaya avashishtam ardham karma karoti. An action that requires more than one day to complete. So dinadvayam sadhya karmanah, a karma that requires more than one day to complete, having done part of the work the previous day, this fellow wakes up and completes the rest of the work. This is what we find. So that's the one karma. Anushabdena pratyabhijna sbhrushyate anusmriti. So that is the anu. By pratyabhijna, he recognizes that I who went to sleep is I who woke up. Smriti shabdena smaranam, again he remembers that I saw this person yesterday, I am seeing him today. Punah pratinyaham pratinyoni pratiyoni adravati adi shabdha Shruti Shabda, in fact. So that is Shruti Shabda, not Adi Shabda. Yeah. So Karmanu Smriti Shabda Vidhibhya. Anyway, I don't know. 5 footnote refers to this Brahma Sutra, Sayavadu, Karma, Anusmati, Shabda, Vedibhyaheti. So all the hetus are given. Anyway, so Pratinyayam, Pratiyoni, Adravati, he returns to the same state by the same root. And Karma Vidya, Videha, Vidishabdita, Vidishabditaha. Not Vidhi, but Vidishabditaha. That all the Vidhis, enjoyment of the rituals and meditations are meant by this word vidhi in that sutra. Iti. Footnote number 6, Anumiti Ityadi. Vedantanaye tarkika vimata vyatireke anumanasthare arthabatti abhivagaman. See, the Nayayikas do not accept a pramana arthabatti, presumption. So, pino devadatta divana bhunte. So, this devadatta who is fat, and does not eat during the day, he must be eating at night. Now this is not called anumanam, it's called arthapatti. Anumanam is when the hetu and the sadhya must be together. So very this dhuma is there, and dhumatvat parvato vanniman, dhuma and vanni both of them are present now. Therefore you infer the presence of vanni from the presence of dhuma. Where is the reference to Devadatta? You see Devadatta now, and he must be eating at some other time. That is how the presumption comes. It's called Anyata Anupattihi. That it cannot be unless he is eating at night. So it is not, there is no connection of Hetu and the Sadhya, the cause and effect is not there. Anyata Anupattihi, this doesn't make sense unless he must be doing it. So we presume. So that's called presumption. And Vedanta accepts this Arthapatya presumption as a separate pramanam, whereas Nayayikas include this in the Anumanam itself. It's a matter of opinion. But then they discuss this, and Vedantins establish this as something separate from Anumanam. So Vedantane Tarkika Abhimata Vyatireke Anumanasthale, instead of Vyatireke Anumana Arthapatya Vyogamat, so Vedantin accept Arthapatya. Anumiyate iti padam kalpiyate iti vivratam. Therefore, Anandagiri said, Bhashyakat anumiyate, so Anandagiri said, kalpiyate, presumed. Iti vivratam. Nanu tvaya kalpimanapi mayana bhivagantavyam iti chet. He says, you are presuming, but I don't accept it. Tatraha svikriyate iti, this is what we accept. प्रमाण अतिक्रमे निर्मर्यादता आपादत्व आपादत्व अपि अभ्युपेतव्यम् इति भावः. प्रमाण अतिक्रमे, इफ यू डोंट एक्सेप्ट द प्रमाण देन देयर इज नो मर्यादा. सो प्रमाण इज देयर, दिस फेलो वेक्स अप एंड सेज दिस, एंड देयरफॉर अर्थापत्ति इज देयर. दैट बीइंग द केस, इफ यू से आई डोंट एक्सेप्ट इट, आई सी इट, आई डोंट एक्सेप्ट इट, सपोज यू से देन निर्मर्यादता आपादत्व. So nirmaryadata apatat, then there is no maryada, there is no rule at all. If you don't accept, from why I see that I don't accept, then there is a rule. And therefore, so you also have to accept that this is what the pramana reveals, and you would accept that. Evam chattad virodascha ityadu anumanapadam arthapatti param taya svikara param va vyakhyamini dhyam. Evam chattad virodascha. So next sentence of Bhashya says, tad virodascha prapnoti anityatve. So tad virodascha ityadau anumanapadam arthapatti param. And so there, anumiyate, Bhashyakara said, anumanapadam arthapatti param, taya svikara param va, or so svikriyate. Either arthapatti or svikriyate. Svikarapana vyakhyamini dhyayam. That is how Anandagiri explained the anumete iti kalpyade svikriyate iti yavat. Okay, so let's go to the last line of the Bhashya on the page 1366. Nityatvam cha.
आत्मनः स्मृत्यादि दर्शनात् अनुमीयते तद्विरोधश्च प्राप्नोति अनित्यत्वे नित्यत्वं च आत्मनः स्मृत्यादर्शनात् अनुमीयते कल्प्यते स्वीक्रियते तद्विरोधश्च. सो दिस इज आनंदगिरि एक्सप्लेन्स तद्विरोधश्च स्मृत्यादि दर्शन कृत आत्मनित्यत्व अनुमान विरोधश्च. इन फैक्ट सो दिस वाक्य अलोन एक्सप्लेन द टीका एवं च तद्विरोधश्च इति आदौ अनुमान पदम. सो तद्विरोधश्च स्मृत्यादि दर्शन कृत आत्मनित्यत्व अनुमान विरोधश्च. तद्विरोधश्च मीन्स व्हाट? तद्विरोधश्च प्राप्नोति अनित्यत्वे. इफ यू से दैट आत्मा इज अनित्य देन दिस विरोध. व्हाट विरोध? स्मृत्यादि दर्शन कृत आत्मनित्यत्व अनुमान विरोध. सो वी इन्फर द नित्यत्वम द इटर्नालिटी ऑफ द आत्मा परसिस्टेंस ऑफ द आत्मा बेस्ड ऑन दिस हेतु नेमली स्मृति कर्म एटसेट्रा. सो दस अवर अनुमान ऑफ इन्फरेंस और अवर अर्थावधि प्रिजम्पशन और अवर स्वीकार ऑफ आत्मा बीइंग नित्य बेस्ड ऑन ऑल दिस डिफरेंट रीजंस ऑफ कर्म अनुस्मृति एंड देन शब्द एंड विधि ऑल ऑफ दिस वुड बी कॉन्ट्रडिक्टेड यू नो. So iti atma nityatva anumana virodhascha, and so that atma is nitya, that svikara will be contradicted. There footnote number 6 said, evam jatad virodhascha ityadav anumana padam arthapatti param taya svikara param va vakyam. So nityatva kalpana or nityatva svikara virodhascha ityartha. Then Bhashyakara continues, Atmana anityatve doshantaramah. So, if Atma is anitya, another dosha also is there. Bhavadati. Bhashya says, Bhavat kalpana anarthakyam cha. And your kalpana also would be meaningless. So what is bhavat kalpana? Says Anandagiri, karma kandasya satyasattvam parena kalpyate. See, all of this discussion, one of the important points of the Purvapakshi was that if you say that brahma satyam jagan mithya, advaita is satyam and dvaita is mithya, in that case karma kanda would become a pramanam. And therefore to establish the pramanyam or the validity of karma kanda, it was necessary for him to establish satyam.